The clear results of last week's election pave the way to the in-or-out referendum on Britain's EU membership. Hello, and welcome to this new issue of ICOT every week. The new UK government ended up less difficult to form than announced by polls. David Cameron will remain the Prime Minister as the Conservatives regained a full majority in the House of Commons after 5 years of a coalition with the Liberal Democrats. Even if his majority is relatively thin, he will be able to implement his full agenda. The pledge has been made to keep on with deficit reduction, a process that began 5 years ago. Now this will be achieved through spending cuts, but beyond the introduction of some caps on social benefits, few details are available. As for taxes, it has been pledged not to raise the VAT rate, while the personal allowance will be revised upwards. But the main focus is on the in-or-out referendum on Britain's EU membership. Promised in early 2013 by David Cameron, it could be organised well before the set deadline of end 2017 and as soon as early next year. The first step in the process is for the UK government to negotiate with the European Union, as this new membership will be the subject of a referendum. What will be discussed is less clear. David Cameron has been mentioning few topics like the flow of workers from other EU countries and their access to the British welfare system. But Jean-Claude Juncker, the president of the European Commission, said that even if he was in favour of a fair deal for Britain, the free movement of workers was a red line. Other topics that preoccupy the British population is the excess of regulation and the loss of power to Brussels. The UK has a history of managing to obtain opt-outs from European treaties, but the real difficulty for David Cameron will be to persuade the most Eurosceptic Conservative MPs and the overall population that this deal is indeed fair for Britain. Indeed, if the British people were to vote for an exit from the European Union, the unity of a country will be put at risk, as a referendum on independence would probably follow in the most Europhile part of a country, beginning with Scotland. As for this week's events, the focus will be on Japanese GDP growth in the first quarter, on April flash PMIs in the Eurozone, and on the US inflation in April. That's all for this time. Have a good read and see you next week for your 2 minutes of economy.
BNP Paribas, la banque d'un monde qui change.